Rare are those who become legends. Rarer still are those who do so during their lifetimes. Singer, actor, playwright, and music composer par excellence, Pankaj Kumar Mallick was one such, who through sheer dint of brilliance and talent, not only became a living legend, but also a revered cultural icon of the nation during his lifetime. A multifaceted genius, Pankaj Mallick straddled the world of music like a colossus. His is a story of humble beginnings, monumental struggles, and glorious achievements. One of the narrow bylanes of North Kolkata, to having a road named after him posthumously, Pankaj Mallick had travelled a long way down the road of music in the 73 glorious years of his life. It all began on the 10th of May 1905, when a son was born to Mona Mohini and Moni Mohan Mallick. The child had four other siblings, but he was the only one who was inclined towards music from a very young age. Although immensely interested in music, young Pankaj was never encouraged to take up music seriously, as public performances of songs other than devotional ones were considered a bit of a taboo for those born into respectable families during those days. Fate, however, had other things in store for him. Durgadash Bondopadhyay, an eminent vocalist of those times, was invited to a devotional soiree at the Mallick residence, where he heard young Pankaj sing in passing. He immediately recognized the talent of the prodigy that Pankaj was and insisted on taking him under his tutelage. Thus began the epic musical odyssey of the boy who the world would, over time, come to know as Pankaj Kumar Mallik. It was a day in 1922, when he went to Durgadas Babu's residence to take music lessons, that he found that his guru was not at home. Waiting for him to return, Pankaj chanced upon a collection of poems by Rabindranath Tagore in a book titled Choyonika. This was a time when songs written by Tagore were usually not heard by the general population, and Pankaj too, being no exception, was blissfully unaware of them. Taking the book to a nearby park, he began reading through it when he came across the poem Chiro Ami, and for some unknown reason the words of the poem riveted his attention. He unwittingly started setting it to tune and began humming it as well. His excitement at having made a song out of a poem propelled him to the nearby premises of the renowned culture club Anand Parishad, where he pounced upon the solitary organ and started to sing. His rendition was, however, cut short when a member of Anand Parishad tapped him on his shoulder and pointed out that, though for most part the tune seemed correct, it was different in a few places. Pankaj was amazed and stunned. How could someone know of the tune he had composed only minutes back? He did not have to wait long for the answer. The poem that Pankaj had composed a while ago had in fact already been set to tune by Rabindranath himself. And uncannily enough, both the tunes had turned out to be quite similar. The song was Jokhon Porbe Na Mor Payre Chinho Ei Bate. It was a momentous occasion for Pankaj. He could never claim the tune to be his, but at that juncture, such an issue seemed inconsequential as the greater picture dawned on him, that of the greatness of Tagore's compositions and his own innate ability to identify with them. From that time onwards, Pankaj became obsessed with Tagore's compositions, and he sought ways and means to learn more about them. His desperation saw him rush to Dinendranath Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore's grand-nephew, quite unannounced. Dinendranath recognized the immense talent in the teenager and agreed to teach him Tagore's songs. He not only taught young Pankaj the true style of rendering Rabindranath's songs, but also the philosophy behind each composition. Pankaj Mallik is universally recognized today as the first man who popularized Rabindrasangeet and spread it among the masses. He did so with missionary zeal and out of the reverential admiration he had for Tagore. The first Rabindrasangeet recorded by Pankaj was published in 1932. Needless to say, it took the audience by storm and thrust Tagore's compositions from elite circles into the realms of popular adoration. Before Pankaj became a recording artist though, he had already become quite popular as a singer on radio, and the story of how he became a radio artist is extremely interesting. The year was 1927 and the month September. Pankaj, struggling under the immense burden of being the sole breadwinner of a joint family of 40, was at that time frantically trying his luck as a jute broker. During one such assignment, a torrential downpour began and Pankaj sought shelter under a nearby portico of a dispensary. The unrelenting rain evoked the song Amona Dine Tare Bola Jai in his mind, and he started to hum the tune, oblivious of his surroundings. His dreamy sojourn ended when the dispensary's doctor, who had obviously been listening to him sing, made an incredible offer, an offer that would change his life forever. The doctor invited Pankaj to sing on radio. Soon Pankaj's dream of making a career out of music became a reality. On 26th September 1927, he started singing on radio, then known as the Indian Broadcasting Company, only a month since its inception in Kolkata. One of the two Rabindrasangeets that he sung on his first day at the radio station was Amona Dine Tare Bola Jai. Radio was at that time the only medium of entertainment in the country, and Pankaj quickly became a household name. This prompted him in 1929 to initiate a pioneering live music class called Sangeet Shikhar Ashur every Sunday morning, which soon had the whole country captivated. He conducted these classes for over four decades, right from 1929 to 1975, an unbelievable feat that has had few parallels in the field of radio broadcast. A major contribution of this program was the impetus it provided in popularizing Rabindrasangeets. Because in the 47 years that Pankaj Mallick conducted the program in his inimitable style, he taught the entire repertoire of Tagore's compositions. His other great milestone, besides Sangeet Shikhar Ashur at All India Radio, was the creation of Mahishasura Mardini. Along with Bani Kumar and Birendra Krishna Bhadru, he gave birth to a program that has now become an inseparable part of the Bengali Pujo culture. This program, which began in 1932, is aired every year at daybreak on Mahalaya, even till today. It had started off as a live performance, but has been broadcast in its recorded format since the late 1960s, and incredibly enough, its incomparable popularity remains undiminished even till today. Durga, Devi Durga.
দেবী অষ্টাদশ ভুজামূর্তি পরিগ্রহ করে শঙ্খে দিলেন ফুৎকার, দেবীর রণ আহ্বান শব্দ অনুসরণ করে সসৈন্যে ধাবমান হল মহাবলশালী মহিষাসুর। অসুররাজ লক্ষ্য করলেন মহালক্ষ্মী দেবীর তেজ প্রভায় ত্রিলোক জ্যোতির্ময়, তার মুকুট গগন চুম্বন করছে, পদভরে পৃথ্বী আনতা আর ধনুকটঙ্কারে রসাতল প্রকম্পিত। দেব সেনাপতি মহাশক্তির জয় মন্ত্রের গুণে দেবীকে দান করলেন মহাপ্রীতি। দেবীর সঙ্গে মহিষাসুরের প্রবল সংগ্রাম আরম্ভ হল। দেবীর অস্ত্রপ্রহারে দৈত্য সেনা ছিন্ন ভিন্ন হতে লাগল। মহিষাসুর অনেকক্ষণে রূপ পরিবর্তন করে নানা কৌশল বিস্তার করলে মহিষ থেকে হস্তি রূপ ধারণ করলে। আবার সিংহরূপী দৈত্যের রণনমত্ততা দেবী প্রসবিত করলেন। পুনরায় নয়ন বিমোহন পুরুষ বেশে আত্মপ্রকাশ করলে ওই ঐন্দ্রজালিক। দেবীর রূঢ় প্রত্যাখ্যান পেয়ে আবার মহিষ মূর্তি গ্রহণ করলে রণবাদ্য দিকে দিগন্তরে নিনাদিত। চতুরঙ্গ নিয়ে অসুরেশ্বর দেবীকে পরাজিত করবার মানসে উল্লসিত। দেবীর বাহন সিংহরাজ তাবাগ্নির মত সমস্ত রণক্ষেত্রে শত্রু নিধারে দুর্নিবার হয়ে উঠল। নানা প্রহরণ ধারিণী দেবী দুর্গা মধুপান করতে করতে মহিষ অসুরকে সদম্ভে বললেন,
ছন্দে শেফালিকা গন্ধে সারুদারে অন্তরে বন্দে শঙ্খের রননে বন্দে শঙ্খের রননে আকাশ যে মধুময় ছন্দে শেফালিকা গন্ধে সারুদারে অন্তরে বন্দে শঙ্খের রণনে বন্দে শঙ্খের রণনে আকাশ যে মধুময় ছন্দে
মনোহর কান্তি জুতে ঐ সুমন 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 সুমনোহর কান্তি জুতে ঐ সুমন 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 সুমনোহর কান্তি জুতে শ্রীতরজনী রজনী 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 করব প্রভৃতে সুনয়ন বি ভ্রমর 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 ভ্রমরাধিপতে জয় জয় সুখানুভবম সুখানুভবম কব চরণং শরণং করবানি ন তামর বানি নিমা শিশিবং কব চরণং শরণং করবানি ন তামর বানি নিমা শিশিবং
the early 1930s, Pankaj Mallick had established himself as an immensely admired radio and recording artist. These facets endeared him to Bengalis all over. But what happened next catapulted him under the spotlight of national and international recognition when he stepped into the world of motion pictures. It was around 1931 that he got drawn into the world of movies, first as a music director conducting live orchestras for silent movies such as Chor Kanta and Chachar Mein, and then composing for talkies produced by International Filmcraft, a company that soon got renamed as New Theatres. After scoring music jointly with Rai Chand Boral for several New Theatres productions between 1931 and 1937, starting with Dena Pauna, Pankaj Mallick became an independent music director with the movie Mukti in 1937. Besides directing the music, he also sang and acted in it. Moreover, it was in Mukti that Rabindrasangeets were used effectively for the first time. Inevitably, the film became a phenomenal success both commercially and critically. Mukti also became famous for one particular song it featured, Diner Sheshe Ghumer Deshe.
चुकी जावार मुखे जाए जरा फेरार पथे फिरे ओ नहीं जाए नामिए मुख चुकी जावार मुखे जाए जरा फेरार पथे फिरे ओ नहीं जाए.
This song was originally a poem titled Shish Khia, written by Tagore. Pankaj Mallick had set it to tune, but to use it in the movie, official permission was required from Tagore himself. Rabindranath not only gave the necessary permission, but also embraced Pankaj and told him to go ahead and set music to those writings of his that he would not be able to convert into songs during his own lifetime. When in 1972, Pankaj Mallick was awarded the prestigious Dada Saheb Phalke Puraskar, the highest honor conferred upon a film personality by the Government of India, his citation included the words, "For his pioneering contributions to the field of Indian film music." These words encapsulated the role Pankaj Mallick played in the context of Indian movies over a period of nearly four decades, a period that saw him display his multifaceted genius in the guise of a singer, composer, and even an actor.
Ore chon chon, ore chon chon, ore chon chon. এই পথে এই যাওয়া এই সুরে এই গাওয়া শেষে নয় সে কথাটি বল করে চঞ্চা তুই চির চেনা মায় ঘাটে লেনা দেনা ঘুরাবে না ঘুরাবে না শুধু চলাচল শুধু চলাচল রে চঞ্চল.
During this time, he enthralled Indians all over the world with his magical melodies and mellifluous singing. His oeuvre included songs in Bengali, Hindi, and Urdu. Songs that have not only withstood the tests of time, but have perpetuated themselves in the magnificent heritage of Indian music. It will not be out of context to mention here that it was with Nitin Bose as the director and Pankaj Mallick and Rai Chand Boral as the joint music directors that the first movie featuring playback singing was introduced to the world of Indian films. The Song of the Sakhis in the 1935 Bengali film Bhagya Chakru and its Hindi version Dhoop Chhaon were the first playback songs to resound in Indian movie theatres. After having composed music for innumerable films for new theatres, the mighty studio, owing to a variety of causes, sadly ground to a standstill by 1955. After that, Pankaj Mallick had no choice but to work with other producers. However, by then he had discovered yet another calling, one that gave him deep satisfaction. In 1953, he was inducted into the Folk Entertainment section of the Government of West Bengal, also known as Lokoranjan Shakha, by the then Chief Minister Dr. Bidhan Chandra Roy. There he was conferred the position of the Honorary Advisor, a post he held till 1968. At Lokoranjan Shakha, he had helped propagate social awareness among the common people of the country through the medium he knew best, music. He conceptualized and directed several music-based productions, which the troupe performed all over the country, as well as in foreign lands. This was also a period when Pankaj Mallick set standards as a recording artist of non-film songs, be they in Bengali, Hindi or Urdu. The songs that he recorded covered varied genres including geets, bhajans and ghazals. It goes without saying that these non-film songs of his, without exception, enthralled the listeners and are still remembered today for their wonderful melodies and lilting tunes. Despite his grueling and hectic schedule, Pankaj Mallick still found time to perform at live shows. These concerts saw him traverse the entire length and breadth of the country. During these shows, he sang a variety of songs that sometimes included Bangla Adhunik Gaan, a genre which he helped revolutionize. During the last stages of his life, when he often looked back upon the amazing musical journey he'd had over seven long decades and the multitude of honors and accolades he had received along the way, he felt proud of only one thing, and that was his success in spreading the grandeur of Rabindrasangeet among the common people. He was also quite thrilled that he had been able to take Tagore's music to the non-Bengali speaking audience as well.
प्राण चाहे नैन न चाहे अरे तू क्यों शर्माए प्राण चाहे नैन न चाहे अरे तू क्यों शर्माए वो आके चल जाए फिर किस लिए साज सजाए प्राण चाहे नैन न चाहे अरे तू
After regaling music lovers for decades with his songs and compositions, Pankaj Mallick left for his heavenly abode on 19th February 1978. His passing away marked the end of an era. Thousands of his admirers took to the roads to bid him a final farewell. Pankaj Mallick may have left us, but his memory still lingers on in our minds, quite like the melodies he left behind for us. The ravages of time have not been able to wipe away his creations from our thoughts. The living legend that he was is now immortalized in the music that he had devoted his entire life to.
Oh, my God.
कदम कदम पर हिलते थे, अब मुझे रखता उजड़ा बन है।